If you're sharing your information that you store in SmartSuite, you absolutely will love dashboards. Dashboards allow you to present your data in meaningful ways and create basically web pages where you can decide exactly who sees what. If you want to learn more about putting together an awesome SmartSuite dashboard, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get the full potential out of your no-code tool suite, and SmartSuite is one of our favorite back-end tools that we love to use. But in this particular video, we're going to be sharing how you can use the front-end capabilities. Building something that looks nice that you can share with external stakeholders, managers, whoever you need to, so that they get access to the information they need without having full-blown access to the back-end data. Well, that is what we're covering here in this video, but before we jump into it, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. If you're new to no-code, automation is going to help you reclaim your time, and it's the same regardless of what no-code tool you use. You have to understand the core framework for automation, and I teach that in my free training that you can grab at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. In that training, I'll teach you how to set up your triggers and actions and start building your own automations in no-code. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of the video. And here we go. In my screen, you can see I've put together some sample sales data. Or to be more accurate, I asked ChatGPT to create some sample sales data for me. I gave it a few different fields. I said, I need a date submitted, I need terms, I need a date received, an amount, and then the status of this payment, whether we received this invoice or not. And you can see that ChatGPT helped me create, 100 records or so. So we are going to be breaking it down in this video, how you can take the data that already lives in SmartSuite and share it in a dashboard. The first thing we need to do is create a new view type. Over here on the left-hand side, you can see I already built a dashboard, but if you're not yet familiar with how to do this, come down to create a new view at the bottom, and you'll have to scroll down to see dashboard. And the little description here is going to tell you that you can use the dashboard and bring in interactive widgets to track key metrics and embed rich content in one powerful view. And that's exactly what we're gonna do. We get to pick all the different components that we bring into our dashboard. So on my dashboard, let me click on over here. The first thing I wanna draw your attention to is that we have multiple different widgets that we've already brought in here, and you can make this however you want. You can include the widgets that you desire, and when you install them, you can then go about editing them so that they display exactly the information you want. One thing you'll notice is that I even have a grid view down here. So I'm able to just access the data source itself and drop the view right in, which makes this a really attractive place to work. Because now I don't need to be in a grid view per se. I could be working right here inside of my dashboard, and then if I need to add new sales data or change the status of something, I have full control over the data here in the dashboard as well. Now, in the upper right corner, you're going to notice that you have the view and edit toggle. When you first build your dashboard, this will automatically be in edit mode because you're in build mode. But once you are ready to deploy the dashboard, you'll want to toggle this to view, and this will then shut down the capabilities of resizing the widgets, adding new widgets, and all of that. It's obviously very easy to get back in here and start adding more stuff. All you have to do, assuming you have the right level of access in SmartSuite, is click on edit. It, and you can then add new widgets to your dashboard. And although SmartSuite is constantly working on bringing out new widgets, they have the basics already here for us, as you can see in the setup here. They even recently released the newest pivot table widget type, which allows us to just drop in, take a look at the different records as they are grouped by rows and columns. So here I've gone ahead and grouped the data by the different terms. On the top here, I've got due on receipt, 30-day and 60-day, and then I have the status of those invoices down on the horizontal. So I've got the status of submitted, paid, and overdue, and we're summing the different totals there. So this is really helpful, right? If I want to figure out, we've got, $28,000 in overdue in the 60-day, invoice terms that we've granted, I can drill in and take a look at the data that makes that up. So of course, pivot tables are really helpful, but not in every situation will you need one. If you do, you now have access to them. But the point of the dashboard is that we can just customize the summarization and the visualization of the data. So go ahead and add the different elements that you'd like. And when you're ready, it's time to share your dashboard. Now to do this, we're going to come into the upper toolbar here. And right now you can see that I've already set this to be shared. Now you have full control over the link that you're setting up here. If you think that it's been compromised, you can crush it, you know, break the link and regenerate a new link immediately. You can also toggle off sharing of the view. So if you feel that maybe somebody who doesn't need to have this information might have received this link, you can just turn it off, disallow them to access it. You'll notice that you have a bunch of different settings as well, and some of them set up to give you even more control over who can see what. So are you going to share all fields or not? You'll hover over here and learn that in sharing fields, you will only allow users to view fields that are included in the view and restrict them from seeing all of the available fields. So if there are a lot of other fields in the table that you don't want people to see, make sure that you are not sharing all fields. Now, you can also allow viewers to open records. And if you enable this, the viewers can open the individual records inside of the different elements they're looking at. So as you see here, when I'm working inside of here, if I'm clicking this, I'm clicking on this bar and it's grouping all of this data, this sales data by month. I can actually drill in and see all of those different November invoices, and I can open them up and get a full view of all of the information on the inside. Back to the different sharing options, we can also display a toolbar. That's this component up here at the top. And then we can also add a passcode so that when you share this information with people, you can have just one more failsafe to make sure that they have your permission to access the data. So I'm here inside of SmartSuite. I'm working in SmartSuite. I'm not looking at the actual live page itself. So in order to do that, we have to make sure that we've toggled on share view, and then we can copy this link and put it into another window, or we can just click right here and say preview the shared link. Now for our example, I'm going to actually open up an incognito window. So I'm going to come down, I use Chrome, I'll right click on it, open an incog window, and now I'm going to paste that URL. And we're going to go visit that live page. So here I am in an incognito window. And the reason I want to bring that up is because this has no idea who I am. It has no idea that I'm also an administrator on this SmartSuite account. And that's important so that you know what your end user is going to experience. So here I am looking at my pivot table. I can look at all the data, all the summarized data. Same thing with the invoices by month. I can hover over and see what the sum of those months were. And I can come down here and see all of the data that was shared inside of this table. So this is the grid view right here. Not to mention, I also have a nice little progress bar up here that's showing us how much of our goal we've received. We set a goal for, you know, $1 million in volume, and we've only reached a quarter mil so far. So we've got some work to do. But I can't do anything else on this particular view because I'm not logged into an account. This is the extent of my interaction, but it's still really slick. I have a fully customized page that someone put together that's driven by all that back-end sales data. And we can actually see how this updates in real time. If I were to really quickly go back into SmartSuite with a quick alt tab, here I am back in SmartSuite. If I go to my grid view, let's say I'm just working around here and we received this one. Let's move it to submitted, right? This is going to increase the amount of money that we are showing back here on our dashboard. We show 266,000 being collected, right? So if I update the status of some of these other sales and I say, oh, great, we received this. This was paid. Let's say this one was paid. And this one was paid. Well, when I come back to my dashboard, I should see that those numbers are actually changing here, right? And when I actually click into my sales collected, I see that I failed to properly set up the filter. I should have applied a filter that said, hey, we're only looking for stuff where the status is paid. Let's go ahead and save those changes. So now we see that we only have 114,000 paid, and let's do that one more time, go back to our actual underlying data and update a few of these to say paid. And I go back now to the dashboard and I see that that number has updated, 119.5. So the whole concept here is that as we're working in our database, we are updating that end result for people who have access to the dashboard. Now, here I am in the incognito window again. I have to refresh this, of course, and then I'm going to see the changes that we just put in where we updated this filter for the status and we see the data reflected here. So we would also, of course, know that these pieces here were previously overdue and are now paid. So dashboards just really give us an amazing way to allow people to visualize our data in a way that actually helps them draw conclusions and do their jobs. I hope you got a ton of value from this video, but any questions we did not address, please be sure to drop them below and feel free to swing by our website and find some help for you. In the meantime, keep on building.